Hello, dissenters. My name is Etalyx, and I am here today returning to Rust. I recently made a video highlighting a build of mine from the last map that my server was playing on before we freshly wiped this past Thursday, called the Citadel, for those of you who missed it. And some of you expressed an interest in seeing a more active build series. So I'm going to be experimenting and testing that out with a little mini series starting today. We're going to be building what I call the barrier. It's mostly a giant wall, and we're going to have a tower in the middle. It's very early stages of construction right now. Excuse me while I loot this airdrop full of delicious supplies, like an AK, for example, an incendiary bullet, and some other goodies. This is what we have so far. Ignore the tower in the center. That's a temporary installment, and that's what we're currently operating out of. We being myself, Runaway X-Con from the last video, and Foist, who's based with me before, so it's a three-person base being made, and of course all three of us are actively gathering and building it up. We start off with just twigs, but very quickly begin upgrading to stone. That's the important thing. With decay, very, very much a threat in Rust, we have to upgrade so that all of our foundations have more hit points and therefore don't disappear. For those of you curious, decay affects twigs especially fast since they only have 5 hit points. Each day that passes within the game of Rust loses some of that hit points and will eventually destroy itself. So you have to upgrade that before the decay occurs to make sure that they're permanent installations. As we walk down the row and upgrade all of the foundations to stone, however, it's not quite as easy as it may first appear. Sometimes when you're making a gigantic base like this, people will harass you from time to time. So if anyone attacks me while I'm building and I happen to be recording, I'd love to share that with you. Who is this? Is that an arrow sticking out of my chest? Luckily, it can't penetrate through the sign armor that I've got on this man. Not lucky enough to have any such armor. The Thompson spraying wildly, landing one hit. Luckily, I brought some extra ammo. Remind me, next week, don't skip target practice. And with a double tap, we ensure that Snagglepuss will not return to harass us while we build this beautiful wall. Is it over? Is that it? There's movement off in the distance. I spot a wolf headdress and produce the bolt action. Direct hit on the first shot, right in the chest, and him running, zigzagging off in the distance, probably bandaging, or perhaps producing his own bow and arrow. Few arrows whiz by as I reappear with the Thompson. That's spray and pray. But I'm not alone anymore. Runaway X-Con has heard the hail of gunfire echoing through the air and arrived just in time to help save the day. Now it's time to loot the spoils of our kills and return to building up the wall to prevent instances like this happening more in the future. Before any kind of wall can go up, though, pillars always come second. First foundations, then pillars, in that order every time, guys. Best thing you can do when making large structures, put a pillar in every available spot. If you don't, you're going to regret it later. If you do and end up not needing them, they're very easy to destroy with a single swing of the hatchet, or of course your hammer, as long as you do it within 10 minutes of placing it and have access to a cupboard. The reason for this is because if you place walls down before pillars, you're going to have big stability problems later on, and resulting in higher level floors crumbling under the lack of supports. When you have all the pillars placed, I think it's also imperative that you upgrade them before doing anything else. I select stone because I don't want people with hatchets to be able to come through and easily destroy my support beams. A wood pillar against a hatchet will not survive. Hatchets are very, very strong against pillars because they're low health, only 125 health for wood and 250 for the stone, so the stone a lot more viable, in my opinion. Now, I never upgrade pillars to armor, but if you have an excess of metal fragments, I guess it can't hurt if you're going ultra secure. But nonetheless, after all of your pillars have been upgraded, hopefully to stone, then it's time for you to begin placing walls. You also notice we have some floor pieces turned into armor. On my server, there is no armor foundation decay, only twig, wood, and stone. So I'm upgrading all those to armor as fast as possible so that they no longer decay, and also because it's important when you're upgrading things to armor to do foundations before you do walls, because people can just pick away at your foundation and then destroy or go underneath your wall to easily raid your base when you might not expect it. I see a lot of people making, say, wooden foundations with stone or higher walls, not realizing that vulnerability. Now, we're going to work on the towers at some point in the future, but for now, I want to focus on the entrance, one of two, to the base, or to the wall, I guess you should say, since the base is inside the wall, at least for now. The way I am wanting to set this up is have windows facing the front porch. That way, if anybody knocks or at the front door and I'm unsure of who's there, or maybe I just want to be extra cautious and make sure no one's camping my front door, I can look through those windows to see. People will camp your front door, wait for you to come out, maybe even kill you before you can shut the door behind you, sneak in, and get the stuff that's in your base. So this is a necessary precaution, but you need to be careful because placing windows on the first floor is a big design flaw unless you secure those windows properly, as I will be doing later. But for all intents and purposes, you want your whole first floor to be windowless, unless you're making extra vacuums and airlocks. So that's why all the way around the first floor of my base, except that entrance, you will find solid walls. Since windows are weaker, they can be cut down or blown up faster depending on what material they're made out of, whereas the walls are a lot more solid with double the HP of the windows. Right now we're outlining one of the six towers that are going to go around the base. You may find some similarities here to the Citadel, but I think as the construction progresses, you'll see some significant differences in look and style, especially given the fact that this time around, we're going to go for a huge spire in the middle as opposed to the little stubbly fort that we had before with the towers on the outside being the tallest. We're going to be reversing that and changing up the interior quite a bit to make it more open. Like I said, it's going to be smaller, but I think it's still going to have a unique design. So we just got done stoning up all of the foundations and floors here, and we're going to continue with the walls all the way around. That is the goal of this particular video, is just getting that wall finalized. And from time to time, we will run out of resources and have to go gather more. And that's one of the things that I'm going to be primarily skipping for you here in this little mini series, is the gathering. Of course, if anything interesting happens while we're gathering, I'll try to show you that. But I want to point it out because it may look like we're only covering a little bit, like, oh, Etalyx, you got a single height wall up. Good. That didn't take you very long, did it? No, it actually took us forever because of all the stone required to reinforce that twig and all the trees that we had to chop down that we're going to have to chop down to make the towers. It just is a massive project, a huge undertaking that really requires all three of us together to combine our efforts to gather as much as we can. The reason I say this is because while it may seem easy, I'm cutting together hours, if not days, of work in progress and condensing it all for you guys so you can get a little abbreviated look and an overhead look too. I'm sure some of you have been clamoring to see Etalyx. What does the whole thing look like? What's the shape? Well, this is what it looks like from above, and it's going to get taller and more menacing looking as the days go by. I'll try to give you guys some more updates along the way through this two-week build process. So if you enjoy it, you like the idea, and you want to see more, let me know what you think down in the comments below, please. I'd love to hear what you think, or if you have any suggestions. It might be too late to suggest them, but you might still have some good ideas, and I hope as the build grows taller and more complex, you might get some ideas for your own creations in Rust. Again, if you haven't checked out the server, please look at the information down below. How to connect is located down there in the link, and I'll try to hit you up with another part of progress in the next few days. Thank you so much for watching. My name is Etalyx, and I'll see you next time.